formally set one of center of mass. Formally set one. Of center of mass. Number one, expression of distance of center of mass of a rigid body from the axis of rotation. Distance of or distance vector of center of mass. Distance vector of center of mass of a rigid body. Rigid body. This is the axis of rotation AB, and we can draw a rigid body in which the distances between its constituent particles remains constant. AB is the axis of rotation about which this rigid body rotates with angular velocity omega. This is the rigid body of mass capital M. We can denote the center of mass of this rigid body. C is the center of mass. C is the center of mass of this rigid body. Center of mass, C is the center of mass of this rigid body. Now we consider a number of constituent particles of this rigid body. M1 is the mass of first constituent particle, which is at a distance R1. This distance can be denoted by this dotted straight line. This distance is R1. R1 is the distance of the constituent particle of mass M1 of the rigid body from the axis of rotation. Similarly, M2 is the mass of the second constituent particle of the rigid body. R2 is the distance of the constituent particle of mass M2. And nth particle is at a distance Rn. Nth constituent particle of mass Mn is at a distance of Rn from the axis of rotation. And C is the center of mass of the rigid body. The distance of this point C, or distance of the center of mass from the axis of rotation AC, AB, is RCM. RCM is the distance of the center of mass of this rigid body having mass capital M, and it consists of a number of constituent particles. Now we consider the same axis of rotation. AB is the same axis of rotation, and entire mass of the rigid body is to be concentrated at the point C. RCM is the distance of the center of mass CM, center of mass, that is the distance of the point C from the axis of rotation is RCM. At C, entire mass capital M of the rigid body has been concentrated, capital M is the concentrated mass of this rigid body, and this concentrated mass capital M will rotate the axis of rotation with the same angular velocity, and the point C will be center of mass, provided the moment of mass of this entire mass of the rigid body concentrated at the point C about the axis of rotation AB will be equal to the sum of moments of mass of its constituent particles about the same axis of rotation. So hence, moment of entire mass capital M concentrated at the center of mass, at the center of mass C, about the axis of rotation AB, axis of rotation AB, will be equal to the sum of moments of mass, sum of moments of mass of the constituent particles of masses m1, m2, ... of the rigid body about the same axis of rotation of the rigid body in which the distance between two constituent particles remains constant, sum of moments of mass of the constituent particles of the rigid body about the same axis of rotation. If this condition is satisfied, then the point C is called center of mass. Therefore, M into RCM is equal to M into RCM. In this case, moment of entire mass of the rigid body about the axis of rotation is M into RCM. M is the entire mass concentrated at the point C. RCM is the distance of center of mass. M RCM equal M1 R1 plus M2 R2 plus ... plus MN. Therefore, RCM is equal M1 R1 plus M2 R2 plus ... plus MN RN whole divided by capital M. That is the expression of distance of center of mass of a rigid body from the axis of rotation. Therefore, RCM equal M1 R1 plus M2 R2 plus ... plus MN RN whole divided by M1 plus M2 plus M3 plus MN. So, this is the distance. This is the distance of center of mass. Distance of center of mass. That is the distance of the point C from the axis of rotation, from the axis of rotation AB, where R1, R2, ... RN are the distances, are the perpendicular distances of the constituent particles of masses M1, M2, masses M1, M2, ... MN of the rigid body of total mass capital M from the axis of rotation AB. Now, the rigid body rotates about the axis AB with angular velocity omega and vector omega, that means angular velocity omega acts vertically upwards. Its constituent particles of masses M1, M2, MN will rotate the same axis of rotation with the same angular velocity omega. For its constituent particles, sum of moments of mass is given by M1 R1 plus M2 R2 plus ... plus MN RN. That is the sum of moments of mass of the constituent particles. Additional information. We can draw the diagram again. AB is the axis of rotation. And at the point C, entire mass of the rigid body is concentrated. AB is the axis of rotation and the concentrated mass rotates about the axis with an angular velocity omega. RCM is the distance, r is the distance of the mass from the axis of rotation. In that case, moment of mass is equal to mass into perpendicular distance of the mass from the axis of rotation. That is moment of mass. Mass into perpendicular distance from the axis of rotation. Therefore, moment of mass is the product of m and r. M into r is the moment of mass. Moment of mass equal m into r. M is the mass and r is the perpendicular distance. Then m into r is the moment of mass. Is the moment of mass. Now we can draw the diagram again. This is the rigid body. AB is the axis of rotation. And this is the rigid body. And the rigid body has the mass capital M. M1 is the mass of the first constituent particle. M1 is the mass of the first constituent particle of the rigid body, which is at a distance r1 from the axis of rotation AB. So this is the distance vector of the first constituent particle of mass M1. R1 vector is the distance vector of the first constituent particle, which has direction away from the axis of rotation as shown in the figure. Similarly, distance vector of the second constituent particle of mass M2 is shown in the figure, which has direction away from the axis of rotation AB. Vector R2 is the distance vector of the second constituent particle of mass M2. Now C is the center of mass of this rigid body. C is the center of mass of this rigid body. And the distance vector of this center of mass from the axis of rotation AB is vector RCM. Vector RCM is the distance vector of the center of mass. Now we can denote the distance vector of the nth constituent particle of mass Mn. Vector Rn is the distance vector of nth constituent particles of mass Mn from the axis of rotation AB. The rigid body rotates about the axis with angular velocity omega. An angular velocity vector acts upwards in vertically upward direction. Vector omega acts provided the rigid body rotates or revolves in a horizontal circular plane about the axis of rotation AB. Therefore, vector RCM equal M1 vector R1 plus M2 vector R2 plus dot 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 plus Mn vector Rn divided by M1 plus M2 plus dot 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 plus Mn. So, vector RCM equal M1 vector R1 plus M2 vector R2 plus dot 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 plus Mn vector Rn divided by sum of masses of all the constituent particles. So vector RCM is the distance vector of the center of mass, that means the distance vector of the point C of the rigid body, from the axis of rotation AB, So vector RCM is the distance vector of the center of mass of the rigid body from the axis of rotation. Now number two topic is what? Position coordinates. Position coordinates of center of mass. Position coordinates of center of mass of a rigid body in three dimension. Position coordinates of center of mass of a rigid body in three dimension. So this is a rigid body of mass capital M. This is a rigid body of mass capital M. M1 is the mass of the first constituent particle, and this first constituent particle has position coordinates x1, y1, comma z1. X1, comma y1, comma z1 is the position coordinates, are the position coordinates of the first constituent particle of mass M1, and this first constituent particle is at a distance x1 along x-axis from the axis of rotation AB. Similarly, the second constituent particle has the position coordinates x2, y2, z2, and this particle is at a distance x2 along x-axis from the axis of rotation AB. And we can assume that the axis of rotation AB is exists at the origin. C is the center of mass of this rigid body having position coordinates. This center of mass C has the position coordinates xcm, ycm, comma zcm, xcm, comma ycm, comma zcm, and this center of mass, that means the point C is at a distance xcm. Xcm is the distance of the point C or center of mass from the axis of rotation. Similarly, nth particle has the position coordinates xn, yn, zn. And this rigid body rotates about the axis AB with an angular velocity omega. In this case, the position coordinate of center of mass along x-axis is what? M1 x1 plus M2 x2 plus dot 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 plus Mn xn whole divided by M1 plus M2 plus dot 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 plus Mn. That is the position coordinate of the center of mass, that is the point that of the point C along x-axis. Similarly, this is xm. Xm is the distance of center of mass along x-axis from the axis of rotation AB or from the origin. Ycm equal M1 Y1, YCM equal M1 Y1 plus M2 Y2 plus dot 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 plus Mn Yn whole divided by M1 plus M2 plus dot 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 plus Mn. YCM is the distance of center of mass. YCM is the distance of center of mass along y-axis from the origin O. Similarly, the expression of ZCM, similarly, the expression of ZCM equal MnZn plus M1Z1 plus M2Z2 plus dot 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 MnZn divided by M1 plus M2 plus dot 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 plus Mn. ZCM is the distance of center of mass. ZCM is the distance of center of mass along Z axis from the origin O. So additional information, RCM, vector RCM, that means distance vector of center of mass from the origin is what? Vector RCM equal M1 vector R1 plus M2 vector R2 plus dot 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 plus Mn vector Rn whole divided by total mass of the rigid body or total mass of the constituent particles of the rigid body, that is m1 plus m2 plus dot 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 plus mn. So this is the distance vector of center of mass from the origin. This is the distance vector of center of mass, from the origin, along distance or vector of center of mass from the axis of rotation. Number three topic is velocity and acceleration. Velocity and acceleration of center of mass. Of a rigid body. Velocity and acceleration of center of mass of a rigid body. Velocity and acceleration of center of mass of a rigid body. So this is a rigid body. AB is the axis of rotation about which the rigid body will rotate. This is the rigid body. And this rigid body has the mass capital M. And we can draw imaginary circular orbit, imaginary horizontal circular orbit, about which the first constituent particle of mass M1 will revolve, and the radius of this circular orbit in horizontal plane is R1. R1 is the radius of the circular orbit in which the first constituent particle will revolve with angular velocity omega. And R1 is also the perpendicular distance, and the first constituent particle will revolve in anticlockwise direction as shown in the figure. And this first constituent particle of mass M1 has tangential velocity V1, which acts inwards, and tangential acceleration A1, which is also acting inwards. And angular velocity will be acting upwards. Angular velocity vector will be acting upwards, provided this particle revolves in anticlockwise direction in horizontal plane. Similarly, this is the circular orbit in which the second constituent particle of mass M2 will revolve with the same angular velocity. M2 is the mass of the second constituent particle. Radius of this circular orbit is R2. R2 is also the perpendicular distance of the second constituent particle of mass M2 from the axis of rotation AB. So R2 is the radius of circular orbit. R2 is the radius of circular orbit in which the second constituent particle will rotate, and this second constituent particle has the tangential velocity V2 and A2 in inward direction, and it has the same angular velocity vector, that is omega vector, which acts vertically upwards. Now we can denote center of mass of this rigid body. We can denote the center of mass of this rigid body, and that center of mass will be revolving in this circular orbit. Center of mass is the point at which entire mass of the rigid body is to be concentrated. So that moment of this center of mass will be equal to sum of moment of its constituent particle about the same axis of rotation. RCM is the perpendicular distance of the point center of mass C from the axis of rotation. Center of mass has the tangential velocity VCM and tangential acceleration ACM. They act inwards. Nth constituent particle will have the tangential velocity Vn and An, and it has also the same angular velocity omega. In this case, center of mass has the same angular velocity omega in vertically upward direction. So we can denote the velocity, tangential velocity and acceleration in vector form. They are denoted by vector v1, vector a1, vector v2, vector a2, vector vcm, vector acm, vector vn and vector an. Now the expression of vector expression of velocity or velocity vector of center of mass is vector vcm, which is m1 vector v1 plus m2 vector v2 plus dot 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 plus mn vector vn, all divided by m1 plus m2 plus dot 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 plus mn. This is the velocity vector of center of mass of a rigid body, vector vcm, equal m1 vector v1 plus m2 vector v2 plus dot 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 mn vector vn, whole divided by sum of masses of all the constituent particles. And this is the velocity vector of center of mass of the rigid body. Similarly, acceleration vector is given by vector acm equal m1 vector a1 plus m2 vector a2 plus dot 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 plus mn vector an, whole divided by m1 plus m2 plus dot 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 plus mn. This is acceleration vector of center of mass. Vector vcm and vector acm both are acting inwards if the rigid body revolves in a circular orbit anti-clockwise direction in horizontal plane. Additional information is we can draw the diagram of two particle system. First particle has the mass m1, which is moving with velocity vector v1, and second particle, which is smaller, which has lesser mass, second particle of mass m2 is moving with velocity v2. And we can assume that velocity m1 will be moving with greater velocity, and C is the center of mass of the two particle system, which exist on the line joining the two particles. Here vector vcm equal m1 vector v1 plus m2 vector v2, whole divided by m1 plus m2. As vector v1 is parallel to vector v2, so vector v1 is parallel to vector v2 in this diagram. Vcm in scalar form, vcm will be m1 v1 plus m2 v2, whole divided by m1 plus m2. So this is the expression of velocity of center of mass of a system of particles in which two particles are moving with different velocities along the same straight line in the same direction. Now, if we consider a system of two particles in which the two particles are moving in the opposite directions, m1 is the mass of the first particle, which is moving with velocity vector b1, and this first particle has greater velocity. As vector v1 velocity of the first particle is opposite to vector v2, that's why vcm will be equal to m1 v1 plus m2 bracket open minus v2 bracket closed divided by m1 plus m2. Therefore vcm equal m1 v1 minus m2 v2 divided by m1 plus m2. So vcm is the velocity of the center of mass of a system of two particles in which two particles are moving in the opposite direction. Also, as vector v1 is greater than vector v2 in this case, therefore vector vcm will be parallel to vector v1 and vector vcm will be opposite to vector v2. That means vector vcm velocity vector of center of mass will be parallel to the greater velocity vector v1 and will be opposite to vector v1 is greater than vector v2. Vector v1 is in the right hand side and v1 greater than v2, that's why the center of mass C will be moving, vcm will be moving in the same direction of v1. Vcm will be parallel to v1 and vector vcm will be opposite to vector v2. In this expression, as v1 is opposite to v2, that's why v2 is negative. Now number 4 topic is nature of, number 4 topic is nature of velocity of center of mass of a rigid body. Nature of velocity of center of mass of a rigid body in the absence of any external force. In the absence of external force. This is the axis of rotation. AB is the axis of rotation. And we have the rigid body. Rigid body has the mass and AB is the axis of rotation. And this is a rigid body. This is a rigid body which has mass capital M. Now this is the circular orbit in horizontal plane in which first constituent particle of mass M1 will be revolving about the axis AB, and the perpendicular distance of this constituent particle is R1 from the axis of rotation. And M1 on this constituent particle, F1i, vector F1i or F1y force is acting. So we can consider the circular orbit in which the second constituent particle of mass M2 will be revolving. And this is the perpendicular distance R2. R2 is the perpendicular distance of second constituent particle of mass M2. On this constituent particle, a force vector F2i will be acting. A force vector F2i will be acting. Vector F2i will be acting in a different direction with respect to vector F1i. Now we can consider the circular orbit in which the center of mass of the body will be revolving. C is the center of mass of this rigid body, and this center of mass has the velocity vector vcm in this direction. Perpendicular distance of center of mass from the axis of rotation is rcm. Now we can consider nth part constituent particle that will revolve in this circular orbit. This nth constituent particle has the mass mn. Perpendicular distance of this nth constituent particle from the axis of rotation AB is Rn. On this constituent particle, a force Fni, vector Fni, is acting in a different direction. Now we can denote the external force which is acted on the center of mass of the rigid body. Fex, vector Fex is the external force, and here we can assume that vector Fex is equal to zero vector because no external force acts on this rigid body. You have to find the nature of velocity of center of mass when no external force acts on this rigid body. vector f e x equal vector f1 I plus vector f2 I plus vector f3 I plus dot 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 plus vector fn I. Therefore, vector f e x equal ddt of change in linear momentum ddt m1 vector v1 plus m2 vector v2 plus dot 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 plus mn vector vn under bracket m1 vector v1 plus m2 vector v2 plus dot 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 plus mn vn is the linear momentum that will be differentiated with respect to time. So vector fex equal ddt under bracket m1 vector v1 plus m2 vector v2 plus dot 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 mn vector vn. So finally we can write vector fex equal m capital M ddt vector vcm. M is the constant we can bring outside ddt operator. So as no external force acts on an isolated system, vector fex will be null vector or zero vector. Therefore, capital M ddt vector vcm equal zero vector. Therefore, ddt of vector vcm equal zero vector. Therefore, vcm equal ddt vcm equal zero. Therefore, vcm equal constant. That means velocity of the center of mass will be constant if no external force acts on this rigid body or on this isolated system. Hence, center of mass of a rigid body will be moving with constant velocity, not variable velocity, will be moving with constant velocity provided no external force acts on it or on the system, on the isolated system or on the rigid body. Now we have to know the distance of center of mass from one of the particles in a system of two particles. We can draw the diagram. This is the straight line on which two particles will exist. This is the first particle of mass m1 at the point T. Which is at a distance r1 from the origin O. Then we can consider another particle m2, another particle of mass m2. At the point B. And this particle of mass m2 is at a distance r2 from the origin. In this case, the origin exists beyond the line joining the two particles. AB is the line joining the two particles, and the origin O exists beyond this line. Now m1 is greater than m2. So first particle is heavier as m1 is greater than m2. In this case, center of mass will be nearer to the heavier particle. C, the center of mass, is at a distance RCM from the origin O. And this center of mass C exists nearer to the heavier body, means exists nearer to the heavier body of mass M1 in comparison to the other mass M2. RCM has the expression M1 R1 plus M2 R2 whole divided by M1 plus M2. So this is the distance, perpendicular distance of center of mass of a system of two particles from the origin provided this origin exists beyond the line joining the two particles, distance of center of mass from the origin O, which exists, that means the origin exists outside the line AB, joining the two particles. This is number one case in which origin exists outside the line joining the two particles. The origin O exists outside the line AB joining two particles M1 and M2. Number two, the origin O exists on the line AB joining the two particles of masses M1 and M2. Joining the two particles so here these are the two particles of mass M1 and M2. Asked particle has the mass M1, which is at the point A, and the second particle, other particle of mass M2, exists at the point B. M2 exists at the point B, and R2 is the distance of the second particle M2, and R1 is the distance of the first particle M1, and the center of mass C exists on the line joining the two particles, and the perpendicular distance RCM from the origin is M1 under bracket minus R1 plus M2 R2 whole divided by M1 plus M2. Here the origin O exists, or the origin O coincides with the center of mass C. As the particle of mass M1 exists on the negative axis of the line joining the two particles with respect to the origin, on the line AB with respect to the origin O, the particle M1 exists on the left hand side of the origin, that's why R1 is negative, and M2 exists on the right hand side, M1 exists on the left hand side with respect to origin O, that's why R1 is negative, that means M1 exists in the negative direction, R1 tends to minus R1, but M2 exists in the positive direction, that's why R2 is positive, R2 tends to plus R2. Or RCM is equal M2 R2 minus M1 R1 divided by M1 plus M2. That is the perpendicular distance of the points here of the center of mass from the origin. This is the distance of center of mass from the origin. As the center of mass, that is C, coincides with the origin O, they are the same point, coincides with the origin O, the distance of center of mass from the origin will be 0, RCM equals 0. Here the origin O, center of mass C coincides with the origin O, that's why RCM equal to 0. Therefore M1R1 minus M2R2 equal 0. Or M1R1 equal M2R2. Or comma M1R1 equal M2 bracket open R minus R1. Here R is the sum of R1 and R2, R equal to R1 plus R2. R means the distance between the two particles, or length of the straight line AB joining the two particles. Two particles exist at A and B. Distance of M1 is R1, distance of M2 is R2 from center of mass, and the total distance between M1 and M2 is R, which is R1 plus R2. R equal to R1 plus R2, that is the total distance between the two particles of masses M1 and M2. So finally we get M1 as M2 divided by M1 plus M2, bracket closed, into R. So R is expressed in terms of total distance between the two particles. R1 equal M2 divided by M1 plus M2 into R. In the numerator we have M2, mass of other particle, and it is divided by sum of masses of the two particles, distance of the particle of mass M1 from center of mass, or from the origin. Similarly, as M1 greater than M2, means the first particle of mass M1 is heavier, that's why center of mass will exist, or will be nearer to the heavier body, will be nearer to the heavier body of mass M1, will be nearer to the heavier particle of mass M1. Similarly, we can write down the expression of R1. Again, R1 is the distance of the first particle of mass M1 from center of mass. And the expression of R2 will be R2 equal M1 divided by M1 plus M2, bracket close, into R. So here distance of the second particle of mass M2 is expressed in terms of total distance between the two particles. R2 equal distance of the particle of mass M2. Distance of the particle of mass M2 from center of mass or from the origin. Here total distance R is R1 plus R2. Now if we divide R1 by R2, then we get M2 by M1. R1 by R2 equal M2 by M1. As M2 less than M1, that's why R1 less than R2. Hence, we can say that the center of mass C. Hence, we can say that as M1 greater than M2, as M1 greater than M2, the center of mass R is the total distance R equal R1 plus R2. Here, M1 is the heavier body, M2 is the lighter body. M1 greater than M2, as M1 greater than M2, that's why R1 less than R2. That means the center of mass C will be nearer to the heavier body.